Okay, children, influenza. Influenza and epidemic. Like what we have today. Coronavirus, because of which you are studying at from home and we are teaching from here. So similar type of epidemic had broken in that period, and the death toll was 20 million people in India, all over India. A communicable disease. What is influenza? Influenza, also called flu or grip, an actual viral infection of the upper and lower respiratory tract that is marked by fever, chills, and a generalized feeling of weakness and pain in the muscles. Today we have a responsible country. Today India is independent and we are struggling to fight against COVID-19. But just imagine, children, those days, an epidemic breaking in a colonial country, what might be the response of the colonial rulers? They die? Okay. We can save as many we can. We are trying. So this was the thing. Next. You can see this. This picture itself shows that this is a basically corridor where the patients are being treated. So you can imagine the actual position of the country, of the hospitals at that point of time. Now, next is increase in price of goods. Increase, now since they wanted money for war, so from where will the money come? From our pockets, from the pockets of the Indians, so they increase the prices of goods. War expenditure means against taxes, and taxes from whom? From the Indian merchants, from the big farmers, from our pocket. Why? To buy weapons. So we have covered all these points by means of this PPT. Once again, nationalism means a feeling of deep love for one's own country. Okay, for which a person is going to do anything. Now the question arises is that why is this chapter being done over here when we've already done it in class 8? Reason behind is that in class 8, we just did a brief introduction of the coming of Gandhiji and civil disobedience movement and Indian national movement, that is India gaining independence, and a bit period after that. But here is just a revision. We are going to go to it more details then. So these are the factors which were prevailing at that point of time between the year 1913 to 1918. So it's important to remember from here, from the board point of view, there are some questions which are important, 1 mark and 3 mark. Now which are these questions? These are, what is forced recruitment for 1 mark? Which epidemic broke out in India in 1920? Then define famine. And the next question which occurs is, discuss the conditions prevailing in India before World War I. Or they may ask you, what were the political conditions, or what are the political and economic conditions, or why was there a chaos in the country? So it can be asked in different way. Okay? Or write a short note on the conditions prevailing in the country before the period 1914, or between 1913 to 1914. So whatever I have explained you up till now, that becomes the answer of the question. Bye. We meet you after this in Gandhiji's return from South Africa. Bye.